In the context of the definition of a shared procedure for the rapid assessment of seismic vulnerability promoted by the Adriseismic project, knowledge activities and detailed studies of masonry and RC buildings have been carried out in recent months. After an initial period of analysis on the state of the art in the countries involved in the project, which covered construction techniques, intervention techniques, existing assessment methods, we are now trying to elaborate a first hypothesis of approach, summarizing the information gathered in the previous phase. The results obtained in this phase, which are still preliminary, are compared with those obtained with traditional procedures in order to receive feedback on the validity of the hypothesis. At the same time, a survey campaign is being carried out on the case study chosen for the city of Bologna, which are the buildings on Piazza Puntoni. The survey will allow to define the most suitable survey method to be applied to the evaluation procedure. I will present below the updates made in the last period on the WPT2. Specifically, I will focus on the Piazza Puntoni surveys and on the adjustments, changes, made to the method of rapid assessment for masonry buildings. The work proceeded in parallel on both areas. From the point of view of the surveys, we finished the digital reconstruction of the square and the buildings facing it. At the same time, we continued the implementation of the method of rapid assessment, improving the evaluation algorithm and introducing the part of the interventions. As for the surveys, after taking photogrammetry of the elevations, we obtained the cadastral plans of all the buildings under investigation, from the ground floor to the top floor. Starting from the individual buildings units, we then reconstructed the entire area in DWG format. This work allowed us to obtain all the dimensional information that could not be obtained from a single analysis of the elevations. The slide shows the PDF of the work obtained for the ground floor, which is now available in DWG format. In the coming weeks, we will proceed with the laser scanning survey of the elevations in order to realize a comparative analysis with respect to what has been obtained through photogrammetry. Obviously, even for a preliminary analysis, the more information that is collected, the more accurate the results will be. The other part of the activities we carried out was the actual evaluation method. Starting from what had already been done, we continued the tests and improved the weights of the evaluation parameters, trying to refine the accuracy of the final outcome. We also introduced some new sheets in which seismic improvement interventions are proposed. Of course, they are that classified in Adriseismic. Currently, the procedure is divided into five phases described in the slide: request for input, state of the art, rapid assessment, class assignment, proposed intervention on masonry, proposed intervention on structure, rapid assessment, new improved class. To show you what has been done, I will illustrate a test carried out on one of the buildings in Piazza Puntoni. The image on the left is a photograph of the building. The one on the right comes from the photogrammetric campaign. The first tables, sheet 1, require information from the operator, that is 1, general data, period and location, 2, general typological information, 3, information about the masonry, 4, information about the construction characteristics. At the end of the experimentation, the spreadsheet will be accompanied by instruction for compilation. Once the input is complete, the system can provide an initial output. The characteristics of the masonry are indicated at the top left, while the kinematics, considered most probable, are indicated at the bottom, with the relative probability of occurrence. In the center is a general class from A, best, to high, worst. The index you see in green represents the hypothetical degree of adequacy of the structure, where 1 is adequate and 0 is totally inadequate. At this point, based on the input provided by a practitioner, the system provides some hypothesis of intervention. This slide shows the ones related to wall quality. It is possible to carry out up to 2 interventions, that is the main and the secondary, as indicated in the relative columns, which you can see on the left. On the right side, the class variation of the masonry is shown in real time according to selected interventions. Interventions can be chosen by simply clicking on the relevant box. The red square, highlighted for readability, identifies the part relating to the main intervention. Here is indicated the secondary intervention. In the same way as for masonry, the system also suggests interventions for macro parts of the structure, that is, foundations, wall panels, floors, and roof. In this case, too, the system of the sheet can choose the most suitable one from the four proposed by the system. The interventions that appear in these screens vary according to the initial input. They should be the most suitable for the structure under investigation. In addition, if no criticality is detected, the message "no intervention needed" appears, as in the case of the foundations. Here are reported the tables for foundations and wall panels. This table, instead, is related to floors and roofs. As can be seen, the logic of the sheet is the same as that described previously. Finally, the last sheet of the system shows the final tab in which the current state of the buildings is compared with the state that can be achieved by the chosen interventions. The comparison is made for all the characteristics analyzed before, therefore, wall quality, damage mechanism, and general index. In this case, it is possible to reach class A with an index of 1.051. The next step we intend to take regarding WPT2 are as follows. 1. Laser scanner survey to validate photogrammetry. Conduct on the elevations of buildings facing the Piazza Puntoni area. 2. Guidelines for the surveys to be carried out by the project partners, specifically for case studies in Croatia and Greece. The last step is further refinement and testing of the evaluation methods. In the coming weeks, we will provide further updates on the status of the work and the results of the pilot cases.